What's going on, guys? It's Mark and Matt.
What's going on? Where are we, bro?
Yo, we're doing something a little bit different. Like we said, we want to be providing you guys with a little bit more content. So today we're coming at you with an all new segment called
What's Poppin Worldwide? Where we're talking about what's poppin worldwide.
Brilliant, bro. Brilliant. You thought about that one. I got to dab that one up.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, guys, we just wanted to give you something else other than podcasts in the weeks where we're not posting a podcast. Because as you know, we're posting every 2 weeks. So this is an opportunity just to chat for a little bit. It's not going to be long about what's happening today across the world.
Yo, let's not waste any time. Let's dive right into this. That Titanic submersible Titan. Bro, that was some crazy shit.
So, you good, bro?
I'm good, bro. Anyway, so for those of you that don't know what it's about, basically, long story short, there was five people on board this submersible. I better be called a submersible or else I fuck this up. Two billionaires, one of the billionaires' sons, the CEO of the company, and somebody else. They were trying to go down to where the Titanic like ruins are, like where the ship still is when it sank. Which is like, what, 12,500 feet?
Correct.
Underwater? Just fucked. Couldn't pay me to go down, let alone these guys pay a quarter mil bro, to get on there.
To get in this thing where you're sitting crisscross applesauce.
It's like a minivan.
The whole way, and you can't even... Bro, you can't even get out from the inside. You're bolted in, 18 bolts, I saw the video, by hand. Not even like... Yeah. By hand. And yeah, you can't even get out. They have to open it up for you to get out. You can't even pay me $250,000 to go down there. You know what I mean?
That's what I just said.
I said it better. Anyways. But yeah. Craziness. So my thing is though, like, it went down on Sunday. And then we finally got what happened on Thursday. However, the Navy knew what happened on the Sunday or the Monday, which was the implosion.
Bro, it's a cover up for something.
You think so?
Think about it. And I actually heard some people say this too. Think about it. It was too like something like there was a new event every day. So Sunday, boom. Monday. Was it? No, wait. Monday. Was it Sunday or Monday that they?
Sunday they went down.
So Sunday we lost whatever of them. Then comms. It was like we have this much. We have this much air left. We're trying to find them. Was it Tuesday they heard banging?
Yeah, they heard banging. And then it went to, they got until early Thursday morning with oxygen, because I think they got 90 hours of oxygen in that thing, in the submersible. Thursday comes around, by this time they're out of oxygen, let's go look for them. And then they
already looking for them, but they just happened on Thursday to find some debris, and then they tested the debris, and then they're like, we're testing the debris, and then it ended up being the debris from that, the pressure tank or whatever. So,
but they knew on Sunday, because it came out literally a couple of days ago, that the Navy had the audio of when it imploded.
They knew right away.
And I also saw a video of the guy from the Navy saying, well, I got this many points. No comms an hour and a half in, and blah, blah, blah. It's an implosion. Like, that's what it is. And it was. So, I don't know, Mark. You tell me. Why? What are they covering? What are they hiding?
I saw this video on TikTok. Apparently, there's some events going on in the world right now. Some Asian dude on TikTok, to be honest. But anyways, got me thinking. Apparently, there were some, 47 million emails that were leaked?
Yeah, between JP Morgan and Epstein, that case.
And then
that
somehow those got deleted. Like, accidentally, 47 million
emails just got wiped by accident. Oops.
And then what was the other thing with Biden?
Yeah, something about, like, Biden facing impeachment in the White House.
That's crazy, man. But, like, you just got to think about, like, the families. Of, like, can you imagine? Like, I try to think, like, yo, imagine. I mean, obviously, I know they didn't really feel shit. But, like, imagine you're, like, all hyped up to go down to see the Titanic.
Well, not all of them. Like, the son was not hyped. He was actually scared. He didn't want to do it. But his dad was such, like, a Titanic lover, connoisseur, or whatever. He just loved the Titanic. And he's like, you know what? I'm gonna go down with my dad. Was it near Father's Day?
I think, yeah, maybe something. That's crazy. Father's Day's.
He also wanted to break a record. Fun fact: he loves Rubik's cubes. He wanted to break the Guinness World Record, like legit. Like he contacted them, he had a camera with him down there, and he was gonna record him doing it at like the lowest point or whatever, the Rubik's Cube. But yeah, that's sad, man.
I think sad. I would rather, like, I would probably go up to space. Like, I would go up to space, yeah. But I would not fucking go that deep underwater. Cause yo, that's because you can drown underwater. I know,
it's in also space. The pressure, bro.
Yeah,
that pressure is crazy. Like one wrong calculation, and you implode.
I mean, probably the same thing with space, but I just feel like
you also don't know what's down there.
Like, the upside to going to space, like the things you can actually see up there, is worth the risk more than like going down to the bottom. Complete of the ocean.
Darkness, bro.
Where?
Like taken, they were in the dark.
Yeah, it's crazy. And like,
and it's cold.
The window like this big.
And it's freezing. Yeah, because there's no sun. Anyway, let's move on. Rest in peace to those five folks.
Speaking of,
but let's add at least 78 more of those.
That's crazy. You talking about that boat off coast of Greece or whatever?
Yeah.
Did you guys hear about that? That's some crazy shit. So apparently they were like, was it legal or illegal migrants from Libya?
I'm pretty sure. I don't know. Probably legal. I don't know though. There was so reportedly approximately 750 migrants going from Libya. They're supposed to go to Italy, and the boat sank.
But they all died. Now some people.
Well, they said 78 dead for sure, but then there's a lot of them missing. Like there was a bunch of kids on there. Bro, that's tough. But my question is, what? How
missing?
How
maybe they made it? Maybe they made it across the border, and they just.
If you see the boat, which we're gonna pop up, like how do you fit 750 people on there, and how do you think it's not gonna sink? You know what I mean? And also, like,
bro, what
they're
do you
talking
mean?
More
Mexicans
about
Mexicans fit 14 family members in a Honda Civic coupe.
But they're not in the water. So.
Yeah. But anyways, I got Mexican friends here. Don't get pissed. Got them. But yeah, that's pretty crazy. That's pretty crazy. Yeah, let's talk about, speaking of crazy, all this smoke in the air.
So what I don't understand with this is, yeah, like in the past couple of years, you see like 1, 2, 3 forest fires, which could be big. But we're talking like 21 plus now.
That's how many they have been total? Like, is this a fact?
Or you're going down the side of your ass? There's a fact. 21, like Quebec included, you know.
Stay hydrated.
What's going on? Because I'm not experiencing no hot weather here. I don't know about you. Maybe a couple weekends.
It's been hot. Like it's been hot. It's been humid as fuck. It just hasn't been sunny.
Like just July, and it hasn't been as hot.
Like
as it should
Canada be. Day is this weekend, and it's raining. And I took a look, and it's obviously it's raining all week. And then I took a look at next week, and it's raining. We need to speak to
Mother Nature,
and tell her, yo, take it easy on us a little bit. Give us, like, please. Let us enjoy 1 month of summer. You know, I think the best day we've had so far has been like in March or like February or something.
Weird.
We had that random weekend.
Like, yeah, and then it like stormed the next week or something.
Yeah, we had a snowstorm.
But yeah, the crazy, going back to the forest fires is like, yeah, it reached New York City, which was crazy, and surroundings, but now it's in Europe. Like,
bro, it's crazy. London. Have you seen the videos? Like, I saw videos of people, like, literally driving in their cars. People driving in their cars, and it's just literally driving through fire. Like, they can't even see.
Yeah, that was crazy. That was like in Alberta, though.
That's where they're happening, man.
Yeah, I know. I thought you meant like the smoke.
No, man. Like we're getting a little bit of smoke here. We're like, yo, imagine them like that.
Must yeah, be I know, but I know it's like not good to inhale, but that shit smells good, bro. It
smells like a bonfire.
Man. Yeah. I almost got my marshmallows out and shit. You know what I mean? And chocolate? Bad joke?
You're an idiot, man. Anyways, before we wrap this up, as you guys know, next Wednesday, we're dropping another episode of the real estate season.
Yes.
It's probably going to be the last one, actually, of the real estate season before we dive into the next season. But you don't want to miss it. We're bringing on a real estate lawyer. Over the past couple of years, there's been a lot of like shit going on in terms of like, you know, people having to back out of new builds they bought. A lot of legal things going on in the real estate business. That's why I wanted to bring a lawyer on to kind of talk to you guys about some of the stories that's been going on. It's actually crazy interesting. Some of you may even want to, you know, pursue a career as a real estate lawyer or in real estate law. This guy's a killer. He's got his own firm. Very successful guy. And we're excited to be bringing you this episode. So make sure you tune in next Wednesday at 8 p.m. for What's Poppin' Wednesdays. Pour yourself a drink.
All right.
Let us know how you like this.
Yeah, so guys, What's Poppin' Worldwide? New segment. Obviously, it's going to get better. We're just sitting around shooting the shits, talking about what's happening. But yeah, just a quick video.
Let us know in the comments.
10-minute video. Let us know what you think.
Does Matthew talk too much?
Did somebody fact check me? Did I flip up somewhere? I'm trying to, like, mom said, relax on the swearing. So I'm trying to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're welcome, mama. But yeah, guys, let us know what you think. We're going to see you in 2 weeks for another What's Poppin' Worldwide. And we're going to see you, as Mark said, this upcoming Wednesday for...
Yo, I got to call you up, bro. Every time I say something, he just repeats what I say and drags the video on, like, unnecessarily, bro. I just said that. Like, why do you need to repeat it?
I just feel like I got to have the final say, bro.
Okay, well, you're the youngin', so sit your ass back. Let me sign off with this. Guys, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter. Matthew's still working on the handle. Follow us on TikTok, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Take it easy. Peace.